We're just leaving the cabin this morning. Nice day, sun's out. We're headed down valley to do some scat collection.
Just got into the middle panther and
bison in the distance.
Up on the hills, pretty amazing.
Just got to one of the bison remote wildlife cameras. We use these cameras for monitoring the bison. It's a good tool to see how they're looking, their body condition and health. So we're just changing batteries, grabbing an SD card quick, and then we'll be on our way to the next camera.
The bison have been using this area a lot. We can see a lot of manure here, and we can see why the bison would enjoy this area. It's blown clear by the wind, and there's lots of grass for forage.
We're collecting some scat samples from the bison. They were here a few days ago to find out exactly what they've been eating. So, I'm just gonna take a little bit of sample and collect it.
So we've finalized the location for a new camera. It's going to be capturing video up above the Panther River. So we've just set it up and tested it. We arm it and then we walk in front of it just to make sure it's capturing the images that we want.
Some important things about this project will just be to learn what the bison do, where do they select for in the summer, where do they spend most of their time, and how do the other wildlife around them interact. It'll be something cool. I'm pretty excited to see what goes on this summer.
We put structures and put monitoring plots in the valley bottoms, thinking they would spend most of their time in the open meadow systems. And we're seeing the bison actually spend a lot of time at very high elevations, right up near the rock, above the tree line. They're using these high alpine habitats on steep slopes.
These are people who have a real sense of the history that they're a part of and historical moment that we're in bringing these bison back to this place. I think everybody sees it as an honor. It allows them to push through the very uncomfortable days, whether that be due to temperature or river crossings or inclement weather. It's not as scheduled when you're in the backcountry. It's not uncommon that you're starting the day by headlamp and you're ending the day by headlamp as well.